So, starting with the name of Almighty Allah, in this video we'll try to learn about the calculations of unconfined compressive strength test of the soil. So from this test we can determine the unconfined compressive strength of the soil and undrained shear strength of the soil. So we'll try to learn the how we can basically perform the calculations of UCS test. So let's start. These are the details of sample. Like in our test, we have the length of the sample as 70 mm and the diameter as 35 mm. Then we have the readings of dial reading. These are basically deformation dial reading. You can see these readings. Then we must record the force values in the test. So we have these two columns. We need to perform the calculations while having these two columns. Now let's start. In the first step, you need to convert your deformation dial reading into mm. So the least count of our apparatus is 0.01. If we multiply our dial reading with 0.01, the value will be converted into mm. So I will select this one, multiply by 0.01. So 0.01 is basically the least count. Now I'll simply drag this value or this formula. So now we have obtained the deformation in millimeter. The next step is to obtain the strain value. Obtain the strain value. So the strain is basically the ratio of original or sorry, the change in length to the original length. So simply divide this value by the original length. So original length of soil sample is 70 mm. Okay, now as we know that this value is constant throughout the column, so that is why we have to place dollar sign to fix it. Now we will drag this. So these are the strain values. Now we have the force value from the observation. We basically record this value performing the test. Now the next step is to determine the stress. So basically the stress or axial stress basically is force per unit area. Now we need to have the cross-sectional area. So we have the dimensions of the sample. We will have to find out the cross-sectional area. As we know that for the circular sample, the formula to determine the cross-sectional area is pi d square divided by 4. So simply pi can be defined as 3.14156 divided by 4. Now multiply bracket, diameter is 35, but we want the value in meter, so we'll divide this value by 1000. So it is basically square. So this is how we can find out the cross-sectional area. We are not applying the area correction in this test. Now to find out the stress, we can simply divide this force by the cross-sectional area. Now again, this area value is constant throughout these columns, so we'll have to place the sign of dollar here. Now we will drag this formula to the whole column. So this is basically the stress value in Newton per meter square. Newtons per meter square. But usually we need the value in kilonewton per meter square. We will simply divide this value by 1000 to obtain the value in kilonewton per meter square. Now the calculations are almost complete. We can reduce the size of decimal places. Now to find out the unconfined compressive strength, that can be represented by QU, small QU basically. It is basically the maximum value out of the stress values. So we will apply the formula of maximum to this column, stress. So maximum out of these values is basically the unconfined compressive strength. So this is the value in kilonewton per meter square. So this is how we can find. So this is how we can find out the unconfined compressive strength of the soil. The second parameter we need to determine from this test is undrained shear strength. So undrained shear strength is basically half of unconfined compressive strength. So we will simply divide this value by 2 to obtain the value of undrained shear strength. So this is the value of undrained shear strength. If you want to convert this value into imperial units, so we can multiply this value by 20.88. So the value will be converted into PSF, pounds per square feet. Simply we can apply the same formula to this column to obtain the value in PSF. So this is how we can perform the calculations of unconfined compressive strength test. If you want to obtain the graph of stress versus strain, we can simply plot the graph between stress and strain. Go to insert, plot a graph. Select data. Along the x-axis we will plot the strain values. So we have the strain values here. And along the y-axis we will plot stress values in kilonewton per meter square. Click OK, and this is how we can plot the graph of stress versus strain. We can define the axis title, like along the x-axis we can define stress in kilonewton per meter square. Okay, it's done. Here we can write the strain value. Yes. And here we can write the title as stress versus strain graph. So now you can see here the maximum value is 189. Kilonewton per meter square, that is unconfined compressive strength. So I hope you like the video. If you like the video, don't forget to subscribe and share. Also join our Facebook page where we provide too much details regarding the geotechnical engineering. So the link is given in the description. So thank you and Allah Hafiz.